Vsauce! Kevin here, headed to the control room of the USS Pasadena, a Los Angeles-class nuclear-powered fast attack submarine. The Pasadena is over 100 meters long, has a crew of nearly 130, and is propelled by a thermal neutron reactor that generates 35,000 shaft horsepower. And it has a lot of buttons, so I'm gonna press this one.
Hey, don't touch that. Or anything.
Right. I'm here with Petty Officer John Davis, Machinist Mate, Nuclear First Class, and trained rescue diver with the United States Navy. I'm 100 meters deep in the Pacific Ocean with an expert in thermodynamics, nuclear reactor technology, fluid dynamics, mathematics, and more. We're going to tap that knowledge to get to the bottom of a game that's been a staple of kitchen tables for a century. Battleship.
Battleship evolved from a pencil and paper French game called L'Attaque, which eventually became Stratego. By the 1960s, Milton Bradley developed the classic 10x10 grid, in which each player places five ships, a carrier that occupies five spaces, a battleship on four, and a cruiser and submarine that are each on three, and a destroyer on two.
Ships can't overlap, but they can touch. The actual gameplay is really simple. The first player guesses a location on the grid, say C4, and the second player says whether that shot hit one of their ships or missed entirely. If it's a miss, then we both mark our grids with a white peg. If it's a hit, then we'll mark it with a red one. The object is to hit each location on all five ships and sink them, and it seems like there's really no perfect way to start. We've got 100 possibilities and all of them equally valid. With 17 possible hits, our first random shot is going to hit about 1 in 5 times. So I'll start. F7.
Miss. Random guesses in Battleship are just a massive exercise in probability, and a simulation by Nick Berry of DataGenetics showed that using this random system means over 99% of games will require at least 78 shots. E7.
Miss. Playing totally randomly would be really, really inefficient, and unless both players are choosing all shots randomly, you'd lose almost every time. And real randomness is actually pretty hard. Research as early as the 1930s showed that humans aren't capable of generating a random number sequence, and modern research in economics shows that decision-making is incredibly difficult when we have to try to make sense of randomness. A3.
Miss. Computers are a lot better at handling randomness, but pure randomness just isn't optimal here. The way most people play Battleship is a blend. First, they shoot randomly until they get a hit, and then they go up, down, left, and right around that hit to find the next part of the ship. D5.
Hit. That's what Barry calls the hunt and target method. You start by randomly firing shots and then work around your hits to sink ships. By repeating that strategy, the average game will take about 65 shots. That's better than random, but it's not great. H8.
Miss. The next level strategy is what's called parity, where you recognize that the board of 100 spaces is actually no more than 50. Because the smallest ship has to occupy at least 2 spaces, we can think of the battleship board like a checkerboard of alternating colors. We can hunt on just one color and then target when we get a hit. D6.
Hit and sunk. Battleship's smallest unit is 2, so once the destroyer has been sunk, like you just did, then that expands to 3, then 4, and 5. Hunt and target with parity improves our average number of moves nearer to 60, so it's a little better, but still not optimal. B2.
Miss. We can employ a rough algorithm in our mind that takes into account both the board and whether ships of a certain length are likely to be in a certain position on that board. G9.
Miss. A computer can do this perfectly, judging the probability of a given ship's length being placed in the leftover spaces on the board. This will change with every single move and will create a sort of heat map and suggests where we should guess next. I'm gonna guess next D4.
Hit.
Haha.
You'll start the game with no information at all, so the best option is to shoot near the center and adjust from there. Guess, recalibrate, repeat, each time refining your probability based on the layout of spaces left and the length of the ships you haven't sunk. 89.
Hit. We can't do this as fast or as perfectly as a computer, but we can generate a pretty good approximation in our minds. As we play each game of Battleship, we're employing a probability density function and refining an algorithm in our brains with every move. Statistically, there's a massive payoff to this approach. It drops the number of shots required into the 30s or 40s, with Berry finding that all 100 million games he simulated were completed by about 65 moves. C4.
Hit. That's how so much of practical math, science, and engineering works. We make an approximation and then hone in on the details the best we can, considering all the variables, unknowns, and randomness, and then put it together with constant adjustments to make something complex function flawlessly. B9.
Hit. It's a constant process, but whether you're optimizing the probability behind a 50-year-old board game or navigating one of the most advanced naval vessels ever created, today we have an opportunity to learn, refine, and evolve faster than ever before.
Wait, did you say before?
Yeah.
Hit. And you sunk my submarine.
Wait, not this submarine.
No.
And as always, thanks for watching. To check out more videos like this, go to sailorverses.com.
Did I say it right? I said it right? Okay, cool.
And it's got a lot of buttons, so I'm gonna touch this one.
Please don't touch that.
Right.
Or anything.
Sorry.
Here we go.
Nuclear. Such an idiot. Okay, yeah, if you like it, I like it.